Hey, thanks so much for tuning in to the Daily Dose for Spiritual Growth. Today is Thoughtful Thursday, and we are on chapter 2 of the book of Romans. And so I'll be reading verses 1 through 4 today. It says, "You therefore have no excuse, you who pass judgment on someone else. For at whatever point you judge another, you are condemning yourself, because you who pass judgment do the same things. Now, we know that God's judgment against those who do such things is based on truth." Yeah. So when you, a mere human being, pass judgment on them and yet do the same things, do you think that you will escape God's judgment? Or do you show contempt for the riches of his kindness, forbearance, and patience, not realizing that God's kindness is intended to lead you to repentance?
Just gonna leave that right there. Okay. Wow. Oh, that's so convicting to your heart, isn't it? Judgment is one of those topics in the Bible that we love to read to tell someone else to stop judging
us. Point.
But when we read it and we allow the Holy Spirit to talk to us, it's convicting. And it's amazing when the Holy Spirit convicts us that he does such in correcting us and rebuking us. And yet, if you've experienced it yourself, you know it's always done with such love, because he cares for us. And that's, I believe, why Paul is writing this as well to the Romans and to us as well, that there's no benefit in judging others. There's none. It might make you feel good for a moment because it makes you feel better about yourself. But really, the Bible is very clear that when we pass judgment on someone else, it's really taking for granted the grace that God has shown us. We are mere humans trying to judge one another, and yet God's judgment is the only righteous judgment.
That's right.
And he has condemned all of us to hell outside of his son, Jesus. And yet through his son's sacrifice, we, very sinful people, very messed up people, very undeserving people, were shown incredible grace through that sacrifice. I challenge you today, as you were reading through that, as we read through it again, would you ask the Lord to reveal to you any judgmental spirit within you? Lord, what areas of my life do I tend to judge people? Do I judge people by their appearance, by their class, by their behavior, by their financial status, by how they treat my kids, by what good of a job they do? What is it? Because we all do. So would you ask the Lord and the Holy Spirit to reveal to you areas of judgment within your own heart, and then ask him to uproot them, to take them out? Ask for repentance for those things and ask him to give you fresh eyes and ears to see others with the grace that he has shown to you.
So good. You know, and as God reveals that to you, may he give you the boldness if you have to take that step to maybe to ask for forgiveness.
Yeah.
So let's do that today.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks so much for tuning in. Make sure to check out tomorrow for another Daily Dose
for spiritual growth.